Welcome guys! In this lesson, we will focus on one of the most important lessons of networking. We will focus inter-VLAN routing. So here, our topology is a router on a stick topology, and we will configure router on a stick topology for inter-VLAN routing. If you are ready, let's go and configure our router and switch. Our IP address configurations has already done, so before our configuration, I'll show you the IP address configurations on the PCs. And here, PC1, and in PC1, let me show you. Yes, this is our IP address, and here is our default gateway IP address, and this default gateway IP address is the IP address of the first subinterface IP address. And again, this is same for the second PC. As you can see, our gateway IP address is same. The interface, the first subinterface of the router IP address. And PC2, the PC2 has this IP address, and the gateway IP address of PC2 is the IP address of the second subinterface here. Again, this is also true for router 3. The default gateway IP address of router 3 is the second interface, subinterface of router's IP address. And the other PCs. And the other PCs are here. As you can see, in different VLANs, we have used different IP address blocks, and the default gateways are going to the different router subinterface. Now let's go to our switch for our configuration. Firstly, I'll create the VLANs here. We will have three VLANs, VLAN 2, VLAN 3, and VLAN 4. So to create VLANs, firstly, I'll go to the configuration mode. And then I'll write VLAN and VLAN ID to create the VLAN. First VLAN 2, VLAN 3, and VLAN 4. We have created our VLANs, and now I will add these VLANs to interfaces, to access interfaces, and then I'll configure trunk interface. So first I'll go to interface fast ethernet 0/2. And then I will configure this interface as access interface with switch port mode access command. And then I will use switch port access VLAN 2 command to add VLAN 2 to this interface. I will also do the same thing for the other interface in this VLAN. Here I wrote wrongly, so I will change it again as fast ethernet 0/3. And again, switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 2. And now I'll configure other interfaces for other VLANs. As you can see, fast ethernet 0/4 and 0/5 are the members of VLAN 3. And for VLAN 4, I will configure fast ethernet 0/6 and 0/7. They are also access ports. Yes, we have finished our access port configurations, and now I'll configure our trunk interface. So our trunk interface will be fast ethernet 0/1, and we will configure this interface as trunk port with switch port mode trunk. And then we will set the allowed VLANs under this trunk with switch port trunk allowed VLAN VLAN ID commands. Sorry, I forgot something. Yes, I will write VLAN 2, 3, and 4. Now we can save our configurations. Let's check also our VLANs that we have created with show VLAN brief command. As you can see, our VLAN 2, 3, and 4 are here. We have created them in this configuration. And there is no fast Ethernet 0/1 because it is a trunk interface. We have finished our VLAN configurations on the switch. Now it is time to configure the most important part for this inter-VLAN configuration. We will configure our router for inter-VLAN routing. So here we will define subinterfaces under the router interface towards the switch. If you are ready, let's go. Here firstly, I'll create the subinterfaces. So to do this, I'll write interface fast Ethernet 0/0.2. So this is our subinterface. And then I will configure the encapsulation with VLAN identifier. So here encapsulation .1Q, we are using .1Q and with VLAN identifier. So here our VLAN identifier is 2. After that, I will configure the subinterface IP address. Remember, we have configured PC's default gateways with these IP addresses. So here I will write this IP address for VLAN 2. The gateway IP address for VLAN 2. This is our IP address for first subinterface. Then I will configure the other two subinterfaces. To do this, I am going to the second subinterface, then I will configure encapsulation .1Q with 3. This time our VLAN identifier is 3 and also our IP address will be different here. And then let's go to the last subinterface and then I will configure encapsulation .1Q with VLAN identifier 4, and then I will configure IP address. Yes. Now let's also go to interface fast Ethernet 0/1 interface. And then use no shutdown command. Yes. Let's save our configuration. And also let's see our interfaces with show IP interface brief command. As you can see, we have an interface here. This interface is the interface between router and switch, and we have defined 3 subinterfaces under this interface. And we have also configured the interface IP addresses, and before we have configured these IP addresses as the default gateway of the PCs. This is the default gateway of VLAN 2, this is the default gateway of VLAN 3, and this is the default gateway of VLAN 4. Yes, we have finished our configurations. It is time for the most funniest part. Ping part. We'll ping between different VLANs and see that if our configurations is okay or not. As you know, network engineers likes pings too much. If you are ready, let's go. Here I'm going to PC0 and here I'll go to command prompt and let's check ipconfig. Yes, our IP address is here. And let's also check the IP address of another PC in another VLAN, PC5, for example. Yes, this is our IP address. Let's ping this PC in VLAN 4 from PC0 in VLAN 2. Are you ready? Yes. Yes, it is working. And let's also ping, for example, this one, or let's check this one. This ping is also successful. The first one is missing because of our process. And let's also ping from PC4 to PC1. Yes. And we have pinged PC0. Now I will ping PC1. Yes, it is working. Yes, guys, we have finished our configuration and verification. Our router on stick topology for inter-VLAN routing is working. If you like this video, please do not forget to like and share with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed yet to our channel, why are you waiting? We are waiting for you. Good luck.